So good morning everyone. So today we'll start with a new topic, that is metabolite transport. Okay, so what do you mean by metabolite transport? In simple sense, metabolite transport is nothing but, let's say for example, this is a cell and these are the nutrients outside the cell, and these are the nutrients inside the cell. Okay, so metabolic transport means movement of solutes or metabolites or nutrients from outside of the cell to inside of the cell, or movement of nutrients, metabolites or solutes from inside of the cell to outside of the cell is called as the metabolite transport in simple sense. Okay, so basically microbes lives in a nutrient poor condition, nutrient poor environment, so they require certain essential nutrients for their various metabolic activities. Okay, so the essential nutrients which are required for their growth, development and metabolic activities are uptaken by the cell, whereas those which are not necessary, unessential nutrients or metabolites, are excreted from the cell to the outside. Okay, clear? So this is the metabolite transport. Okay, so next, if this is a cell and here they have the cell membrane, so as we know, microorganisms have cell membrane or plasma membrane, which is made up of lipid. Okay, and lipid is bilayered. Okay, so the cell membrane is lipid bilayered. Okay, so this cell membrane or the plasma membrane is lipophilic in nature. Lipophilic in nature. So what do you mean by lipophilic? Lipophilic means nothing but they are lipid loving. Okay, so the cell membrane of microorganism are lipid loving. So what they do, they allow certain lipid molecules, like example cholesterol, okay, to pass through this membrane. Okay, without any barrier, this lipid molecule can pass through the cell membrane. Okay, along with the lipid molecules, some small molecules like water, oxygen or carbon dioxide may also pass through this membrane. Okay, clear? See, the cell of microorganisms consisting of the lipid bilayer. Okay, so lipid bilayer is lipophilic in nature. That means the lipophilic means what? They are lipid loving. So they allow certain lipid or some small molecules like water, oxygen and then carbon dioxide to pass from the exterior to the interior of the cell. The external environment of the cell is known as the extracellular space, and the interior of the cell is known as the intercellular space. Clear? Okay, fine. Now what happens if the concentration For example, if the concentration of lipid molecules or water molecules or oxygen molecules or carbon dioxide molecules is higher in extracellular space than the intracellular space, okay, if the concentration of the lipid or the molecules or the solutes is higher in extracellular space or the outside the cell, then what happens? These molecules starts moving from the exterior to the interior. That means the intracellular space. Okay? So there is a concentration gradient. Fine? So concentration gradient is nothing but here the concentration of the solutes or the metabolites is higher, but here the concentration is lower. So there is a difference in the concentration. Okay, so there is a difference in the concentration, and that is the concentration gradient. So what happens, the molecules from higher concentration gradient to lower concentration, they start moving. Okay, so movement of molecules started from higher concentration level to lower concentration level. Okay, after some time, what happens? There will be an equilibrium. There will be an equilibrium means the molecules of outside the cell and inside the cell will be same, will be in equilibrium state. So after the condition reached equilibrium state, there will be no movement of solute or other molecules. Fine. So this process, movement of molecules or solutes or metabolites from higher concentration to lower concentration level, is known as the passive diffusion, or simply it is called as diffusion. Clear? So movement of or transport of molecules from higher concentration level to lower concentration level, or from cell exterior to cell interior, is known as the passive diffusion or simply diffusion. Okay, the rate of passive diffusion obviously depends on the concentration gradient between the cell exterior and the its interior. Okay, clear? Fine. Okay, now for large molecules, okay, so this is for small molecules or lipids, etc. Now for large molecules, or ions or polar molecules is conferred to the cytoplasmic membrane by two types of membrane proteins. Okay, two types of membrane proteins. So, in simple sense, what to the large molecules to pass through this membrane, there is certain membrane proteins. Okay, so basically two membrane proteins are available. They are known as pumps and channels. Okay, pumps and channels. Clear? So two membrane proteins are there, pumps and channels, which can carry the large molecule from exterior to interior of the cell. Okay, fine. Okay, while pumps are able to transport molecules against concentration gradient, molecules against concentration gradient by using ATP or light. So pumps require ATP or light, okay? Pumps require ATP or light to transport molecules against concentration gradient through the membrane, while the channels allow uptake, through the membrane in a downhill direction only, okay? Pumps require ATP and light, okay? While the channels allow uptake through the membrane in a downhill direction only. Okay. Thus, the pump action illustrates the active and group translocation. While as the channels, okay, while the channel action illustrates the passive and facilitated diffusion. Okay, clear? Okay. But while most essential nutrients can diffuse through the outer membrane, all require one or more transport system to cross the inner membrane and gain access to the cytoplasm. The goal of most of this transport system is to concentrate nutrients inside the cell that may be in short supply externally. Okay, so we'll discuss in details about the passive and facilitated transport in the next class.